there, Simplifiers. Welcome back to my organizing ABCs, where today we are talking about F is for false hopes. If you're anything like me, you could waste a good amount of time binge watching some HGTV or DIY network if you had some spare time on your hands. I love watching these shows to get ideas for my own home and for my clients' homes. It is kind of amazing what they do in a short amount of time. But what you don't see is that just because this family has a beautifully decorated and organized home doesn't mean that the work has been done to maintain that organization. You also don't see all of the people working in the background to help get it done. Now, don't get me wrong, I love the magic of television. That's what keeps bringing me back. But I've seen time and time again where people get discouraged in their organizing projects because things aren't moving along quickly enough. What may take days or weeks on a television show could take you months or even years in your own home because you don't have a whole crew of people working behind you. You don't necessarily have a professional organizer or an interior designer. I see people get discouraged that they aren't making as quick a progress as they would like to on their projects. So here's my advice to you. Start with something small, like the top of your desk or the top of your dresser or your junk drawer, something that won't take you a really long time to finish and that you can work at maintaining. Because maintenance is a part of organizing. It's not just set it and forget it when it comes to the organizing projects around your home. You are going to have to continually put effort into maintaining those spaces that have been organized. So start with something small that you know you can work at, and then work yourself up to larger projects like the garage, or the basement, or the attic, or your kids' clothes when they've already moved out of the house and are off at college. Starting small will help to build your confidence in your organizing skills and not discourage you from tackling those larger projects that you want to do. What's an area of your home that you would like to get organized? Please comment below and let me know what is on your organizing agenda. And make sure that you subscribe so that you don't miss any of my organizing ABCs. And I will catch you back here tomorrow when we discuss G is for goal setting.